Welcome to the Mayor's Message of June 26, 2020. I'm Mayor Ron Jensen. Last week, our police department, in partnership with the Grand Prairie NAACP and LULAC chapters, hosted a unity rally, which was well attended. And even though we saw a great deal of solidarity in ending racism at the event, make no mistake, we've got work to do. Of course, that's easy to say. We need to do better. It's not always easy to do. There will be setbacks. But we must show progress. Real change takes time, and the time to start is now. One way we can do better is to get to know each other better. Here's a video of our police department recently launched that helps us do just that.
Habari gani? Jina langu ni Frank Obudo. Natoka Nairobi, Kenya.
Oi, meu nome é Marcos, e eu sou brasileiro.
Hello, my name's Samantha. I'm a veteran and a mother.
Xin chào, tôi tên là Thái và tôi đến từ Việt Nam.
Hello, I'm Brandon and I sang opera professionally.
Hi, my name is Robert and I play pro football.
And I am a Grand Prairie police officer.
And I'm 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 Daniel Sesney, father, Marine Corps veteran, and Grand Prairie police chief. And like all Grand Prairie police officers, one with our community.
You know, none of us are perfect, but I believe we have one of the best police departments in the country. They embraced community policing almost a decade ago and continuously tried to improve their service to our community. As this video shows, our police officers are from all walks of life, sons and daughters, husbands and wives, and we appreciate your support of the work they do to make Grand Prairie a great place to live for all of us. On Tuesday, June 23rd, Governor Abbott warned of the rapid spread as a new single-day high number of new cases in Texas surpassed 5,000. He said Texans should stay home and avoid gatherings for the 4th of July holiday. He's also expanding the ability of local governments to impose restrictions on outdoor gatherings to no more than 100, down from the previous limit of no more than 500 people. The day before, at a press conference on June 22nd, the governor reported that statewide, the virus is spreading at an unacceptable rate. The numbers of daily positives increased May to June from about 1,500 per day to about 3,500 a day. Positive cases increased from 4.5% in May to 9.5% in June. Hospitalizations in May were around 1,600, and now it's up to 3,700. TABC is closing down bars, not practicing safe guidelines. Wearing a mask will help us keep Texas open, and closing Texas businesses again is a last resort. He realizes some people felt like wearing a mask is inconvenient, or that it's an infringement upon their freedom. But wearing a mask will help us keep Texas open. He warned that if numbers continue to double by next month, stricter guidelines will have to be implemented. He says we must maintain flexibility so the right strategy is in place for the right county. In March, Dallas County residents age 40 and younger made up 40% of COVID-19 cases. In June, those younger than 40 were 60% of the new cases. A couple of weeks ago, the judge in Bexar County issued new rules requiring businesses in Bexar County to require masks being worn by employees and patrons. Governor Abbott allowed that to happen and said other counties could. So just last week, Dallas County imposed the same rules in Dallas County. And as of Thursday morning, Tarrant County passed orders similar to Dallas County and other counties across the state of Texas. It requires businesses to mandate masks for employees and customers if social distancing cannot be maintained. It also limits gatherings to no more than 100 people, and all must wear masks. It strongly urges people 10 years and older to wear a mask and to socially distance when out. Folks, please wear your mask. We have to get control of this pandemic. We continue to offer free drive-through and at-home COVID-19 testing for people who live and work in Grand Prairie. This service will continue through mid-July. We also know that some of the new operators may not have known that Grand Prairie is offering this as a free service. If they try to charge you, ask for a supervisor. As I mentioned last week, City Council approved funding rental, mortgage, and utility assistance for residents affected by COVID-19. This is through our partner, Grand Prairie United Charities. The Emergency Assistance Program is now available for application, and all the details can be found on our website, gptx.org. Council also approved emergency assistance for Grand Prairie businesses affected by COVID-19 in partnership with Dallas and Tarrant County. In Dallas County, applications will be taken through June 28th. Tarrant County applications will be taken from June 22nd through July 1st. Again, the details are on our website. The Chamber of Commerce is helping businesses with this application process. As of Wednesday, June 24th at 5 p.m., Grand Prairie had 729 cases of COVID-19 in Dallas County with 17 deaths and 155 in Tarrant County with one death, for a total of 821 cases and 18 deaths. You can find all this information on gptx.org. Looking at the 7-day rolling average trends, both Dallas and Tarrant County number of new cases continues to rise. Dallas County has had more than 15 days in a row of more than 300 positive cases a day and more than 8 days in a row at the 400 plus mark. The COVID-19 pandemic and shutdown have also had a significant impact on the city's budget. For fiscal year 2020 through 2021, we're facing a loss of about $14 million. Look, folks, we're all worried about this. The numbers are not going down, they're going up. I, along with everybody in the city, along with other mayors across the state, want to keep Texas open. The governor wants to keep Texas open. Let's do what the governor's suggesting. Let's stay home if you don't need to get out. When you do get out, wear a mask. Practice social distancing. Wash your hands. We need to get control of this. We want to give the governor every opportunity to open more up, not close things down. I'll see you next week.